Managing KiCad projects can get out of hand very easily. That's the reason we made last two videos discussing how to manage KiCad projects effectively using Git and GitHub. Similarly, managing KiCad external libraries can be cumbersome when you try to use the same library collection over multiple projects. So in this video, we'll see how we can fix these issues by using Git Submodules. Before starting, make sure you have a local Git repository in your machine with a custom footprint symbols that you like to use. Then make sure this repo is hosted online and synced with GitHub. If you are unsure what's happening and wondering how to set this up, make sure to watch the previous two videos explaining how to use Git and GitHub. In this video, we'll be using Git's very less known feature called Git Submodules. This will help us link one repository to another repository as a dependency. This way we can avoid or at least reduce a lot of time in developing the same footprint and symbols. And also this will make the library centralized for all the project that we'll be working on. This way we can make the changes to footprint and symbol only once and it will be reflected in all the projects. Anyway, let's see how we can implement this in KiCad. We'll be using this project from the previous video where we have the circuit, PCB layout and a lot of versioning going on. Now to create a submodule for this project, open the project in the File Explorer and then open Git Bash. Here, use the command submodule add followed by the library repository link. And we'll add the path where to download this submodule. I'll use this path. With this, we have the external library setup. Let's import few of them and try it out in KiCad. Open the schematic editor and then go to Preference and click on Manage Symbol Libraries. And here, click on Project Specific Library. And here, add the path to the symbol by using the plus icon. In my case, this is my location. Seems a little too long. Also, if I try to push this to GitHub, anyone who likes to open the project won't have access to the same path in their system. To solve this, KiCad offers a few keywords, which can be used. In this case, I'll use the keyword KiCad project mod. Let's quickly check if this works. Yes, we just added the symbol successfully. We can follow the same process on PCB layout editor to add footprint to the KiCad project. With this, we have linked our library repository with our project repository. Let's push this change to GitHub and see how these files are updated in the project repository. Here we can see a new file called .gitmodules is added. And when you open this file, you can see we have the URL to the KiCad library project. And when we open the URL, we go to the library repository. But how does adding a library submodule help? Well, first we'll have a centralized location to dump all our custom footprints and symbol and reuse it in multiple projects. Then any mistakes in footprint or symbols can be fixed once and it will be automatically updated on every project. Finally, it's a great way to collaborate with a large team who are working on a large number of projects. This is not necessarily the best way to manage and handle library files. There are other options like maintaining your own database or using a dedicated third-party application. But if you're anyway using Git and GitHub in your workflow, this method would make it much easier to maintain and share your KiCad library files. With this, we have come to the end of the video. I would love to credit these two videos which made this video possible. So make sure to check it out for more information about Git submodules and how to use them with KiCad. If you have any questions or doubt, make sure to drop your questions at PCBCupid. And if you like this kind of content, make sure to subscribe to the channel and share it with people who would love this. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.